Everything is doing well. Everything's attached. Everything's put back to where it was, and feeling good, ready to get the season started.
You know, the consensus was last year after you had your surgery, you had dropped a considerable amount of weight, and some people who saw you were frightened by how much weight you had lost. So we understand somewhere between 15 and 30 pounds. That's all back on. You are feeling pretty good.
Yes, sir. All the weight's back on, healthy, and you know, just post surgery stuff where you know you lose your muscle, and you know your eating probably isn't what it should be because you just don't feel like eating because you're in pain. Or so yeah, everything's back on, healthy, and ready to get the season started.
How tough was your recovery, Bobby?
As far as physical conditioning, right, it wasn't tough at all. It was just time-consuming, a lot of sitting around and waiting for the bones to fuse together. And, you know, that's all it was just time. And sometimes that's hard to do, is sit back and let it happen. But I feel like I've been smart about it this offseason, and, you know, feel like everything is going together, and the doctors are happy, the Mets are happy. So next step is just to start ramping up the conditioning and get ready for the season.
Is there even the slightest doubt in your mind, Bob, that you're going to be back and better than ever?
No, I definitely will. I feel like, you know, even though I got hurt at the end of the year last year, you know, I feel like I still learned a lot about myself. I learned a lot about the game. And, you know, looking forward to bringing that over into this next year. And, you know, I feel like I still have a lot to accomplish, and nowhere near being done. Yeah, you know, I think just the role changes you as a pitcher. You know, you have to succeed in order to win a ball game. And, you know, 7th, 8th, 6th, 5th, wherever you pitch there, is, you know, you got some room for error. And the 9th inning, you have no room for error. So you have to be on top of your game. And you better figure it out pretty quickly. And, you know, I had some years in there where I could learn and figure out my routine. And I felt like I had a good routine last year, and confidence was high. So I think everything clicked for me last year.
Your strikeout numbers, they were down last season, but so were the walks and the home runs. So what adjustments went into that?
I knew that if I fell behind hitters or toyed with hitters, that, you know, you give up weak hits and walks. And, you know, I just wanted to attack hitters. I wanted early contact. I wanted ground balls early. And, you know, it's kind of a mindset is, you know, get in. I'd rather have three outs and three pitches than, you know, sit there and try to strike them out and throw 15. And if I threw 15 or 20 pitches, then, you know, I'd be tired for the next day. So throw as few pitches as possible and be ready for the next day is kind of what the goal was.
We've seen you mature as a pitcher right before our eyes, Bob. And you throw the fastball less now than you did in the past. Is it difficult for you to back off the fastball velocity at times?
I'm learning to. Obviously, when I was younger, that's, you know, what got me to the big leagues. And, you know, I thought that's what was going to keep me there. But I soon realized that, you know, getting outs is the name of the game, and it doesn't matter how you do it. You know, I was fortunate enough that, you know, Jason Isringhausen taught me how to throw a curveball. And, you know, I learned to get hitters off my fastball by using that pitch. And, you know, it's actually been a good out pitch for me as well, too.
What about that knuckle curve? You mentioned you learned it from, perfected it with the help of Izzy. Are you using that differently, Bob, than you might have in the past?
Yeah, as I get more confidence with it, it's becoming a first pitch strike pitch where, you know, I just attack the hitter with it, just to, you know, get him thinking of what he's going to get next. And, you know, use it in situations where normally I wouldn't. And, you know, it's worked.